This is a dirted tank, my 170-gallon jungle ecosystem, complete with an array of plants, fish, and a menagerie of creatures that live together in a complex food web. This adventure, which began 180 days ago, is more than just a typical aquarium. It's an ecosystem that becomes more beautiful over time. If you're ready, I'd like to tell you step by step how I set up this ecosystem. Welcome to Piece of Nature. The foundation of our ecosystem is dirt. Yes, you heard it right. The soil we know. I took enough soil from my own garden and sifted it to separate it from unwanted materials. This soil we've taken should be free from fertilizers. Here is the perfect soil we need. I added sifted soil to the bottom of the aquarium, about 2 inches thick, and moistened it. This is river sand. I got it from a construction company near my house. It doesn't leach into the water and is quite natural. Moreover, it's very cheap. I washed the sand with water until the dirt was gone and carefully covered the top of the soil. As usual, I'm out in nature gathering the rocks and woods I need. Nature offers us perfect opportunities. Please give it a chance. It doesn't mean we can use everything we find in nature. According to the system we've set up and the creatures that will inhabit it, we should conduct our research. I arranged the decor according to my own plan and preference. Since these woods won't sink immediately, I secured them to each other with tissue paper and super glue. After a few hours of effort, I achieved this view. For this 660-liter, 170-gallon tank, I needed a significant amount of plants. I purchased all the plants from a local plant grower who sent me perfect plants. In dirted tanks like this, starting with plenty of plants is highly beneficial. These plants will absorb nutrients from the soil and prevent potential algae issues. Additionally, they will produce oxygen for the aquatic inhabitants. I won't be using a filter in this aquarium. These plants you see will filter the water. I'm familiar with the tap water in my city, so I use dechlorinated tap water in my aquariums. However, tap water varies everywhere. Therefore, do not use the tap water in your aquarium without being sure about the tap water in your area. After filling the tank with water, I added a few different types of floating plants. Floating plants quickly consume nitrates in the water and visually enhance natural-looking aquariums. Additionally, I'm using a small water pump to create some movement in the water. On the second day, I transferred the first inhabitants of our ecosystem, the nereid snails, to their new home. These snails are excellent algae eaters and also enjoy consuming decaying plant leaves. The next day, it was time to enhance the ecosystem's filtration system. The Monstera plant is a great choice for this task. Its roots can adapt to being positioned in water. First, I cleaned the soil from the roots under running water without damaging them. Then, I secured the plant to the aquarium glass using wire wrapped around the plant stem. This way, the plant's roots will be submerged in the water while the rest of it remains above water. At the end of the first week, I introduced over 100 Bloody Mary shrimp to the ecosystem. These shrimp will help us combat algae and serve as a great food source for our fish, thanks to their rapid reproduction rates. This will also help us control their population growth, just like in nature. On the 10th day, I added assassin snails to the tank. Most likely, pet snails came with the plants, and assassin snails will feed on these pet snails. The reproduction rates of pet snails are excessively high. Therefore, I got assassin snails to control their population. Assassin snails cannot harm nereid snails. They are only a threat to smaller snails. A week later, I introduced fish from many different species into the ecosystem. These fish are all compatible with each other. Their colors are a bit faded at the moment, due to the long journey. They will showcase their beauty in a few days. On the 18th day, I treated the inhabitants to brine shrimp. This high-protein food was greatly enjoyed by the fish. 1 month after the ecosystem met with water, the plants adapted and started to grow. The water quality began to improve. The ecosystem is still new, and the food web has not yet formed. We need some more time for that. That's why I'm feeding the fish a bit more than usual. And I have to say, I haven't done any water changes. In the past 15 days, the plants have grown considerably. The fish and other creatures continue to live in harmony. The ecosystem keeps developing. By the 60th day, the overall appearance of the tank had reached this point. There was a slight algae formation on the glass, which I cleaned off with a toothbrush. Additionally, I pruned some plants and replanted them in new locations. I still haven't done a water change. On the 90th day, I added new plants and fish to the tank. The more plants we add to this ecosystem, the more productivity we'll achieve. It's also important to keep the number of fish in check. When feeding the fish, we should avoid overfeeding. On the 100th day, I made a big mistake. While trying to catch fish for my other aquariums, I disturbed the substrate of this ecosystem too much. This led to the formation of various types of algae. The water became quite cloudy. Within 24 hours, I started to see intense algae growth on almost every plant. How can we combat these algae without using chemicals? Firstly, I will reduce the light duration from 8 hours to 4 hours per day. Additionally, I will temporarily decrease the amount of food given to the fish. These two factors are the most important natural weapons in the fight against algae. Excess light and overfeeding serve as nutrients for algae. How much food do we need to give to the fish? I want to explain this. If the food we give stays in the water or on the surface for minutes, it's overfeeding. If the food we give is consumed by the fish within seconds, it's adequate feeding. A month later, the algae disappeared. As I mentioned, I reduced the lighting duration and feeding. I didn't do anything else. The plants showed good development during this time. The tank water is almost crystal clear. I can revert the light level back to its previous state. I'm happy that the algae disappeared without using chemicals. After weeks, I finally started seeing small creatures within the ecosystem. The quality of my phone camera wasn't enough to show you these creatures, so I couldn't record them. As a result, a food web is starting to form. It's truly a time-consuming process. Many plants have grown excessively, especially the lotus plant, which has covered the water surface. I prune these plants to encourage new fresh shoots. Also, I clean the algae on the glass again with a toothbrush. I've done these procedures a few times since setting up the tank. And here we are on the final day of this series. The ecosystem is 6 months old. During this time, some plants didn't adapt well, while others thrived. Many different kinds of fish came and went. In these 6 months, I've learned 4 important lessons. We shouldn't overfeed our fish. We shouldn't overcrowd our aquarium. We need to choose appropriate lighting for our tank, and we shouldn't interfere too much with the ecosystem. I didn't change the water or use a filter in this tank. I'm not saying never to use a filter or change the water. Every ecosystem is different, with different dynamics and loads. I just wanted to show that you can have a beautiful ecosystem without using a filter or changing the water. We've come a long way with this tank. It was exciting to follow its journey from the day it was set up to where it is now. The ecosystem is really settling in and continuing its life. Now, it's time for me to sit back and enjoy watching it thrive. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would be very happy if you subscribe and support. Also, I think you'll like the video I recommend at the end of this one. As always, Thank you so much for watching. Peace and love.